I just pulled out the camera out of the glove box, nearing the Arab village just before Argamon. That is in the Dead Sea Valley Road, and I had a shot fired right into my windshield, and it hit it from a low trajectory, and as you can see, it is a low trajectory, and so it glanced upwards. The inside of the car is full of glass. I've got glass all over me, but this is to get a record of this, no matter what takes place. Heading south on the Dead Sea Valley Road, the Arab village just before Argamon, approaching that is where apparently there were no vehicles around, nothing was around, and apparently this shot, we see no police officers at all, and so no military. So as soon as I find one, I'm going to then give them the detail on it, and I'm going to keep on going. I've got no time for these silly shenanigans. Here we go. Here we go. Okay, there's a police officer back there. Wow, he was sleeping 100 miles an hour and he didn't even pull out to get me. So, okay, here we go. I'll put up a little right here. Okay, I just reported to police. They are taking off and going up there right now. I told them where it happened, and I said, I'm heading to Jerusalem. They said, go, go. So, we are going. We are going. I was just reminiscing about some of the comments I got on my YouTube video that I put up concerning the Gaza flotilla, and one of them in particular was saying how the Israelis, they're the ones that probably staged this whole thing, and that the guys in masks were probably Mossad, and this is all to make the Arabs look bad. So, okay, you may think that. So all these people that out there that think that you know, Israel is the instigator of all these things, whatever fairy tale world you live in, the world of denial, you know, have at it. But this is getting ready to ramp up. This is Michael Rood, Highway 90, Dead Sea Valley, with a bullet hole and glass throughout the car and right at my chest. But it appears that the Almighty is able to protect us even at point blank range with a high powered rifle. So, peace. Shalom to our fans. This is Michael Rood, and it is true that I got shot today in the Dead Sea Valley, but the bullet didn't come all the way through the windshield, and so I'm in Jerusalem. I got a quick shower, changed my shirt, got the glass shrapnel off my body, and I'm here to tell you a little bit about what happened today. As I left the Galilee on my way to Jerusalem before Shabbat, I was on my way to pick up Yishai Reinhardt from the Hands of Mercy and to take him down to Sderot. And on my way, driving up the Dead Sea Valley, going around a curve toward Iraq, as I was nearing an Arab village just on the north end of Argamon, that is when I received a direct hit and into the windshield. And so everything is fine. I was shot, but the bullet didn't go through. It was going right for my chest, but thankfully it didn't go through. So now I want to introduce you to Yishai Reinhardt. Yishai? Good to be alive, living and breathing with you.
Thank you.
Yishai and I, we met each other in my office in Michigan. And after spending about an hour together, we found out that we were both from Lincoln Avenue Baptist Church in Ionia, Michigan. Yishai was in the Marines, and we were praying for him. You got injured in combat, yes, and very life-threatening. I remember praying for him for a long time, all of his brothers and sisters. I went to young people, Sunday school, and also high school with, and I saw Yishai as he came in after he was somewhat recovered, and just briefly, he came into a Sunday morning service, and then he was gone. Didn't see him again until we found out that we're both living in Israel. Yishai is a director of Hands of Mercy, who helps the war wounded, the victims of terror in Sderot, has been ministering for many years here in the land of Israel. And so I'm doing all the talking, Yishai, but since you're a former Marine, looking at that that wound, what do you think we have here? 7.62 millimeter or 30 caliber, or do we have a 5.56 millimeter round?
It looks like at least a 7.62 millimeter.
Okay.
So it's a pretty powerful round, and depending on from the trajectory, it glanced up, and thank God, bless the Lord, it didn't come through the windshield, because it would have came right into your chest. So God is so good and merciful to all of us living here in the land of Israel. He's got the Shomer protecting us and keeping us safe from all of the attacks of the enemy. You can see with the intensity of hatred toward Israel now, we are going to get more and more attacks on our lives within the land as well as without the land, just because we identify with the God of Israel and that we are Jews.
That's right. And my problems with a 7.62 millimeter is nothing compared to what you face on a regular basis down in Sderot. Those rockets that are coming in are big, are they not?
They still are coming. There was a lull for about 2-3 months as they were trying to make peace, false peace. And now they're starting to come back again because the Palestinians just across the border into Gaza are realizing that the peace is not working, and there's enough terror groups, cell groups, that want to express their hatred toward us, and that the mm-hmm. best way they can do it is what they've got in their hands. They take cut off a pole, that's maybe a stop sign, take the machine shop, do some work on it, put explosive in it, the charge, and they got a nice big city called Sderot to hit within the community boundaries of the city. Mm-hmm. So we are sitting there, sitting ducks, but we've got a wonderful Shomer, guardian, who never slumbers and never sleeps and is protecting us. So mm-hmm. That's a praise report to our Almighty God.
Yeah, that's right. We are going to take people in another interview. We're going to take them down to your ministry and to show them around down there so that they'll get a little bit more familiar with what you're doing there. But I think it's important to state that the rockets that are coming in there are fairly simple, but there have been over 10,000 of them.
Yes.
That have come into Sderot. Mm-hmm. And everyone has to be within 15 seconds of a bomber shelter, because when the siren goes off, that's what you've got, right?
Yes.
15 seconds or less before the incoming actually hits.
There are times when there's no warning. The army somehow misses getting the warning to us as in the city, and there all of a sudden it'll hit. And this happened numerous times, that we had just suddenly an explosion, and it was like, oops, there was no warning. And we just know that God is goodness and His mercy is taking care of us.
That's right. Now, this week it's especially important to note that the reason why they're just small rockets is because there is an Egyptian-Israeli blockade to keep ships from coming into Gaza to deliver the heavy warheads.
Yes.
And that is the reason why big stuff is not coming in to Sderot at this point. Here are a couple of ex-Marines, non-combatants here in the land of Israel, just doing our best to minister, to take care of people, and I really appreciate what you're doing, brother, and keep up the good work down there with Hands of Mercy and Sderot.